again, it's Glenn Walford here from franchisebuyer.com.au, and I'm out and about again today, and I'm at the offices of Burger Urge here at Newfarm in Brisbane, and I'm joined today by Sean Carthew and Tom Potter. Sean, how you going, mate?
Hello, how are you?
Tom?
Good to see you again.
Thanks, mate. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me at these fine offices. Very, very funky and cool. Mate, Sean, Burger Urge, tell me, we came across at the Brisbane Expo recently.
Yeah.
We talked a little bit about the brand, but tell me about the brand.
We started the business in 2007. I started with my brother. We've been operational for 7 years now. We've got 7 sites on the ground.
Yep.
We've got another 3 under construction. We'll have 10 stores by Christmas, and we've moved into franchising. We're looking to double that number in 2014.
Excellent. Excellent. 2015. Okay, so 10 stores by Christmas, and hopefully up to 20 stores by that time next year.
Yep.
And we've got the esteemed Tom Potter, obviously. Tom's very well known in the franchising sector.
Yep.
What's the connection with Tom?
Originally, I read an article in BRW, I think it was about 2008, Tom had just sold Eagle Boys,
mm-hmm.
And for whatever reason, it sort of jumped out at me, and I thought, we need this guy's help. So I looked him up on a property database and wrote a letter and sent it to his house, and 48 hours later, I got a phone call from Tom's PA and said, Tom wants to know how you know where he lives.
So he was freaked out.
And he will agree to meet with you. So we had an initial meeting with Tom. He came into our Fortitude Valley store and sort of struck up a relationship from there. We've been dealing with Tom.
Yeah, basically doing some mentoring for the first few years.
And that's formalised now, obviously, is it?
Yeah, more so in a structured role here as chair, and working still as in a mentoring and strategic role for the boys. I'm going to say that the actual industry, the fast casual food industry, really didn't exist 20 plus years ago when Eagle Boys was running, and now the fast casual industry has become an area that is just probably the fastest moving sector in the food market itself.
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah.
You've seen concepts pop up in all different sort of categories over all over the place.
Yeah. The whole concept of being able to walk in, served and be fed in and out in 30 minutes is something that really didn't exist 20 years ago, and now is enormous.
So what attracted you to Burger Urge? What and Sean? And
look, it's a little bit similar to Eagle Boys.
Mm-hmm.
A startup, a niche in the market. The boys have got a very good product. They can build the stores in a tighter space than the major competitors such as Grilled.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very well accepted product, both on what is sold and also the way it's price positioned.
Yes.
So I actually saw a lot of similarities to Eagle Boys. Mm-hmm. We know what our market is, we know what our niche is, we know what our competition are doing. I'm actually quite excited about the opportunity in the brand. Yeah.
And what's your day-to-day role, and how do you actually work in with the brand?
Some days I'm not in here at all. Some mm-hmm. weeks they won't hear from me, but it's more about monthly board meetings, overseeing strategy, getting involved with policy decisions, and when the odd problem comes up and the boys need someone to bounce it off, I'm there. Not dissimilar to my previous chairman, John Cozzi. He was very much someone there. Yeah, he was very much someone that could help you, guide you down that road while you were surrounded by a lot of noise and a lot of things that were going on, to keep your head clear.
Mm, okay. So Sean, what's the key focus? You said up to 20 stores hopefully by the end of next year. What areas are you focusing on?
Immediate growth is in Southeast Queensland.
Mm-hmm.
We want to try and dominate the Brisbane, Greater Brisbane market before we look regionally and interstate. We've got a 3-year plan to open 41 stores, and ultimately we'll expand into the other major cities and potentially overseas.
Mm-hmm.
But the immediate focus is here. We know this market very well.
Yeah. And I know you recently, you assisted your time with the acquisition of a brand in Victoria,
right? So we acquired the master franchise rights to the Urban Burger brand, which was initially from Melbourne.
Yes.
They opened 10 sites. And they've had some issues in more recent years.
Mm.
So we've acquired that business, and we're in the process of converting the existing stores to our brand.
And that's the 10 stores in Victoria, or are you?
There's 4 locations in Queensland. We've already made the first conversion in Salisbury. That store's trading very well at the moment. We're looking at another three conversions in the next 12 months.
Okay, excellent. So it's sounding like it's very much on the go. It's going to be a busy next 12 to 18 months for you.
Yeah, we've got three new sites under construction. We're building a store at the moment in Southland Parklands, which is due to open in a week's time.
Yes.
We're building a store in Logan Hyperdome, and that's going to open in October. We've also got a store in the Brisbane International Airport coming online in November.
And what's interesting is the brand's evolving. I'm sure it's talking about going into airports, talking about going into Logan Hyperdome.
And new spaces.
Big traffic, yeah. So the brand's literally getting to a stage where it can open in two styles of outlets. One of them is in a micro site where you've got the high traffic, and the other one's going to be in a macro site where we can get both high traffic and also high access to, you know, dining and so forth. So the brand's really got some interesting opportunity coming up at the moment.
So you're really effectively really opening up your options when it comes to sites, yeah, and so on going forward as well.
It's not like we want to be all things to all people, but I think when you're totally siloed in one market, you're missing opportunity. And when Eagle Boys had drive-throughs and its standard sites and its micro sites, we actually could capture quite a lot of those opportunities, and those are certainly things that have been looked at by Burger Edge as well.
Excellent. Okay, well, Sean Carthew, Tom Potter, thanks so much for joining us today.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir. Thanks, Tom. That's Glenn again from franchisebuyer.com.au, and we'll catch you again soon.